Yeah, I mean, it really is hard to pick one phase of the game to really talk about and be like, this is what we were able to expose. But I mean, the reality is we were pretty much able to do whatever we wanted. When our starters were in the game, I think Jordan Travis's stat line, he only attempted 12 passes and he had over 200 yards and three touchdowns. And then on the ground, you had Trey Benson, 15 carries, 128 yards, two touchdowns. Our starting offense was could have named the score. And so while I would have liked, to hang 70 on them, or at least get the record for the series, right? Did you see that graphic during the broadcast? So I think we tied for the third largest deficit with 2 years ago, but it was the other way for the COVID year where Miami beat the brakes off of us. So we just returned the favor, 42 point win.
I think you and I talked about this earlier in the week, and I know I've heard maybe it was Danny Cannell say it earlier in the week that he kind of felt like tonight would be a reverse of the 2020 game, and it was.
He nailed it. Yeah.
And Cannell is going to have some fun on Monday on his radio shows.
Oh, yeah.
No,
He
nobody
always does.
control like he can. Yeah. It like you said as we were talking about it, you don't even really know what to say. I mean, 62 passing yards for Miami, 128 rushing yards, and most of those just kind of unbroken scrambles by Johnson. And I haven't gone through and looked at it, but I think probably majority of those rushing yards against backup defense for Florida State. I mean, you still hold them to under 200 total yards. Was never really pressured defensively. I mean, they made that nice pick on a ball that probably got away from Travis just a little bit, but other than that, I mean, you'd have to get really nitpicky, I feel like, tonight. I mean, whatever happened with Span there towards the end of the game, that might have been the most negative thing on the game for Florida State.
Yeah. Well, I mean, as the game got away from them, the Miami players were getting pretty chippy. They were kind of looking to fight whoever they could pick one with. And it looked like was it on the goal line? When was that Span was getting the dressing down? I'd have to go back and look,
I think it
but
was the second to last offensive series for Florida State. It was like a, I don't know, third and
no, because
long.
it followed a punt, or it preceded a punt. They punted right after that. Yeah, so it couldn't have been on the goal line. No, but it was like just some extracurricular stuff after the play, and Span bought into it, and so he got the flag, and then Norvell got in his face. But it was cool to see, going right back to him on the next offensive series after him and Norvell kind of like had it out on the sideline. They got him back in the game, got him refocused, and he put some punishment on a couple of Miami defensive backs after
Oh
he
my
caught
goodness.
that.
And I think that that's what's been pretty definitely encouraging to see the last 2 weeks is you see the second team get in, and I mean they're just playing hard, scoring that touchdown again with what probably in when Ward's healthy, that's what a fourth or fifth string running back.
Yeah.
And one thing that I really liked was I think when it was still 31-3, it might have been 38-3, and there was a big, I say big, there was a third down or a fourth
It's
down.
so hard to remember. We were up by so much the whole game. It's hard to remember what exactly the score was.